How will the hospital of the future will look like? What will be the picture that the patient sees when he comes to the hospital? And I think I'm really convinced that there will be a dramatic difference in how we build hospitals in the future compared to how we build hospitals today. In essence, what we do right now is we build the hospital around the physicians. We basically build the hospitals even more focused around the chairman of the department of medicine, of surgery, of radiology. The future will be that we center the hospitals around the patients. I mean, this is what we have to learn from industry. It's customer orientation. It's patient orientation. And we have to build and design our hospitals that the patient journey is enjoyable because the patients are our customers. And when we build the hospital on a patient-focused way, and we have an example how we do this with our new children's hospital here at Freiburg University, the hospitals look completely different and they are a lot more efficient. And quality is improved because you don't lose the patient on the patient journey. And then the second part is the workflow. Again, the patient journey has to be seamless. The patients outside of the hospital are used to seamless one-stop processes. They sit on their couch in front of the TV in the evening and with their iPhone, with their iPad, they order something and the next day it's there. When they move into the hospital, they stand in queues in front of people where they fill in paper forms. And this will also change. So we will have in the next couple of years digital onboarding processes like you're used from your airplanes. You check in the day before you come. You get a reminder where to come and when to come. And you have a digital assistant, app-based. We have what we call Meine Uniklinik app, which is our local app where we guide the patients. And this helps the patient to find the way through the 6 days the patient spends in the hospital. And the patients want this, they request it, they are used to it, and we need to deliver this to the patient. So again, patient empowerment, giving the information to the patient, improves quality. We are not losing our patients during their journey, and everybody will be satisfied with that picture then. When we talk about the future of quality in medicine, digitalization is the tool to establish what we call quality in real time. When we look at the process of quality management as it's done in the traditional way right now, we treat and then we document in the afternoon or the next day or even days after the patient has left the hospital. And then at the end of the quarter or at the end of the year, the quality management team comes, looks at the data, talks about the results, 6% wound infection, that's not good, do something differently in the future. When we talk about quality in real time and the use of digitalization, we have sensors that monitor the process in real time. And when something goes wrong, we immediately get the red flag, and the patient that is within the process benefits from this approach of quality in real time. The logic is a little bit like the lane assist in car driving or autonomous driving, that you get immediate feedback on what you do. And this is for me the future of quality in medicine, quality in real time, and that's only possible with digitalization. When I look into the future of cancer treatment, I see several developments. We will see more and new technical devices decreasing the radicality of the approach and also increasing the standardization. When we talk about robotic assistance and other things in surgery, this actually increases the standardization and by this increases quality. The second big field where we see changes is data-driven medicine. When we look outside of the hospitals, when you look what Google Maps does, what other data-driven companies do, we need to bring their intelligence into the hospital because we use too few data on the patients right now. We are basically blind to what happens to the patient before and after the hospital stay. So we see the patient for 6 days. And there's a lot of data out there of the patient's behavior before the hospital. where the sickness relevant parameters are actually there. And then when the patient leaves the hospital, we talk about the outcome measurements. And we have to change our approach in medicine, especially in cancer medicine, when we talk about the patient-reported outcome measurements. We see the patient on a fixed schedule every 6 weeks, every 3 months, and we are blind to what happens between these visits. And some patients need to come more often, and a lot of patients do not have to come so often. And with monitoring devices and sensor systems, we can move from this one-size-fits-all follow-up scheme to an adaptive follow-up scheme where the patient who needs the physician encounter gets it, and those patients who don't need it don't need to come and don't need to be bothered. And this is the future in cancer treatment, where we see the technological developments and also the digital developments in order to improve outcome. When we talk about sustainability in healthcare, we have to define the term sustainability first. And of course, when we talk about sustainability in general, it's ecological sustainability. But sustainability in our mind is also economic and social. So when we start with the ecological sustainability, this means that as a hospital, we are an energy consumption intensive organization. So we have to cut down our energy consumption. We have to look for ways to preserve energy. We right now produce 70,000 tons of CO2 per year. And we have a program in the next years that we reduce this by 20,000 tons CO2 per year. And this is achievable in the not so far future. And then when we talk about economic sustainability, again, this means that we take care of what we have, that we are not demolishing our expensive equipment and other things, that we reduce also waste, and by this, again, create a good economic environment. And also quality medicine is economic sustainability, because quality medicine means I do exactly the right thing, not too much and not too little. And by this, it's also economic sustainability. And part three is the social sustainability. And the social sustainability, again, our employees, our members of the team are our most precious resource that we have in the hospital. So we have to take care that our members of the team stay healthy and they stay at the workplace. So the social sustainability is also a very important aspect of our work. And we talk about sustainability, ecological, economical, and social. This is our task. Of course, it's always difficult to make predictions about the future, but it's interesting to think about it. And what we will see is that we are in some aspects, we are actually returning to the initial idea of healthcare. When we look 200 years back, there were no hospitals. Healthcare was delivered on a home basis. The physician was coming to the people, and of course the poor had no access, but the rich people, the physicians, were coming to their homes. And then one started to build hospitals. Florence Nightingale and others started that development. Hospitals were hospitals for the poor, for the sick and poor, and they were coming to the hospitals. And then over the last 100 years, healthcare was concentrated in the hospitals. And in the last, say, 20, 25 years, we have learned that acute care in the hospital is only one aspect, and that chronic outpatient care is getting more and more important. So when we look in the future, we will see more focus on prevention, keeping the people healthy, and healthcare delivery will go outside of the hospital, more into the ambient and the home care setting. And you have assist devices that monitor the patient in the home setting and support the patient in the home setting. So this is really interesting. This goes basically back 200, 300 years, where home care was standard of care. So this may be an aspect of the future of healthcare when we look at 30, 40 years into the future.